Joseph, who now, at that time, is not the chief just yet, it was about 12 years ago, and they started a very good relationship, and Chief Joseph said, I'm going to come to your house someday. And about a year or two later, knock on the door, and there's Chief Joseph standing at my door, and he's been coming ever since. And I'm doing some fundraising to try to make their life better. Because right now, they've been following the life that they've been living for 600 years, and now the government of Africa is saying, you can't be nomads anymore. You gotta stay put, and you gotta get educated. And that's what they're doing. They're educating their people, and they're bringing it into the 21st century, but not losing their culture.
We are visiting from East Africa, Kenya. And I come from a tribal group of people called the Maasai people of Kenya. And when visiting, we are representing our people as cultural ambassadors. And when we are here, the main purpose of coming to share our way of life or our culture is to give people to come and understand the diverse cultures of the world, come and appreciate for a peaceful global world. So that's why we visit.
When I say super, you respond by saying Ipa, meaning we are now exchanging greetings. So teachers, boys and girls, super.
Ipa.
Thank you very much. Again, the Maasai are livestock keepers. They keep cows, sheep, goats, and donkeys. And the reason as to why the Maasai keep donkeys, it is being used as the beast of burden, because it is used as a means of transport, to transport the elderly people, the sick, the children, whenever we move from one place to another, and also it is used to go and to fetch water by the Maasai women, because some women walk up to 3, 4, 5 or more miles to get clean water for drinking and cooking. As a community, we pass knowledge from one generation to another through an informal way of learning. So you don't have to go to school in order for you to learn about the traditions, the culture, or the Maasai way of life. Our knowledge is passed through stories, through songs, through practice, and through observation.
We have body rhythms like that, and then our vocal sound. So that's what we do. Okay. Yeah.